On this episode, we're going to help you figure out how much it's going to cost to charge your Model 3 next on Now You Know. So maybe you're already on the reservation list for the Model 3, or maybe you're still running the numbers to see if it makes sense for you. Either way, you know that traditionally, one of the biggest expenses in owning any car is the cost to power it. We've been driving our Model 3 for a few months now, so we have a good idea of what it's going to cost you. We've all grown up with ICE, or internal combustion engine cars, so most people know what they cost to fuel. You take the number of miles that you expect to drive in a year, and divide that by the miles per gallon, and multiply that by the current price of gas per gallon. So for instance, this 2018 Audi A4, which starts at $36,000, is a pretty good equivalent to the Model 3 in terms of size and price, and it gets up to 27 miles per gallon city, 37 miles per gallon highway. If we were considering buying this Audi, and let's say we drive the number of miles that an average American does every year, 12,000 miles, and the price of gas is $2.49 per gallon, we'd be looking at around 375 gallons of gas, or $933 per year in gasoline. With an electric car, it's a similar calculation, but the terms are new and a bit strange to us because we're not used to them yet. To help us compare apples to apples when looking at different cars, the EPA rates electric cars with MPGe, or miles per gallon equivalent, even though EVs like the Model 3 don't burn gasoline. The Model 3 has an MPGe of 126. Now that is helpful if we compare it to the Audi, with an average MPG of 32, because we can see that the Model 3 gets almost 100 miles more per gallon equivalent. But it's not exactly helpful in figuring out our actual electricity costs in running the Model 3.
With the Model 3, we now have to deal with the price of electricity, or price per kilowatt hour, instead of the price of a gallon of gasoline. And we have to adjust ourselves to miles per kilowatt hour instead of miles per gallon.
Okay, so let's figure this out. First, let's figure out how many miles per kilowatt hour it takes to drive the Model 3. The rated miles per kilowatt hour for the Model 3 with the long-range battery is 4.15 miles per kilowatt hour.
A kilowatt hour of electricity costs anywhere from about 8 cents per kilowatt hour in Washington or Louisiana to our home state of Massachusetts, which has one of the highest prices of electricity at 22 cents per kilowatt hour. The average cost of electricity in the United States is 13 cents per kilowatt hour.
So let's say you plan on driving 12,000 miles a year in the Model 3, and you live in Washington State. So you divide 12,000 miles by 4.15 miles per kilowatt hour, and you get 2,892 kilowatt hours of electricity. Now multiply that by the price in Washington of 8 cents per kilowatt hour, and we get $231.
If you live in Massachusetts, that same 12,000 miles would cost you $636.
You can look at your electricity bill and see the rate you are paying and figure out how much it will cost to charge at home. Keep in mind that many states have lower rates during off-peak times of day, and you can usually take advantage of this by telling the Model 3 when to start charging. In fact, you're helping the grid too when you charge off-peak, so it's a win-win.
If you want to know how much it will cost to charge at a supercharger, just go to this Tesla link and look up the state you'll be charging in and use that price per kilowatt hour.
If you don't want to do any math, but just want to get a sense of what the Model 3 will save you compared to a comparable ICE car like the Audi A4, then let's use averages.
We'll pretend that you drive the average 12,000 miles per year and pay the average 13 cents per kilowatt hour for the Model 3 and $2.49 a gallon for that Audi. So here it is with the math done for you. The Audi will cost $933 and the Model 3 will cost $375. That's $558 less per year.
As you can see, electric cars like the Model 3 are far more energy efficient than ICE cars and cost a lot less to power.
The average American keeps their car for about 7 years, so that would be a savings of almost $4,000.
And this is if gas and electricity prices stay where they are. Because oil is a finite resource and gets harder to discover, drill, and pump, it is expected to go up in price. Whereas electricity, which is being made more and more by the sun and wind every year, is going to get cheaper.
As these two prices continue to grow apart, it will get cheaper and cheaper to drive electric, and more expensive to drive an ICE car. Now you know.
Thanks so much for watching Now You Know. We work hard to bring you videos about things that we think you'll find useful, but we need to know from you what you want to see, so leave your comments below. Also, don't forget to go over to our Patreon page, where for as little as a buck a month, you can watch our Patreon bonus story every week on Tesla Time News. Thanks again. We'll see you soon.